In this tutorial, we'll see how to use Cinemachine to let the camera follow the player. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hi everyone, this is Omar Balfiki. If you're a subscriber, welcome back. If not, welcome to this channel where I create Unity game development tutorials and from time to time I upload my short films. If you're interested, hit the subscribe button and don't forget the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is uploaded. In today's video, I'll just give you a brief and a short intro to Cinemachine and how to use it to make the camera follow the player. And the cool thing about it, it's just straightforward, few steps with no coding required. If this is your first time using Cinemachine, probably you don't have it installed. To install it, go to Window and then Package Manager. Make sure all packages is selected. Scroll till you find Cinemachine, select it and install it. After it's installed, you'll see a new menu, Cinemachine. If you click on it, you'll see a lot of different options and different types of cameras. But as of this tutorial scope, we'll just create a virtual camera. You'll see a new virtual camera created, and then you'll notice that there is an icon next to our main camera. This icon is to indicate that it has a Cinemachine brain component. Cinemachine uses two main components. First, the Cinemachine brain component, which is the decision maker. And then we've got the Cinemachine virtual camera. And virtual camera, as the name suggests, they're empty game objects with Cinemachine virtual camera component that acts as a real camera. So if I move the virtual camera, you'll see that our camera is moving with it. If I duplicate it, it will go to the newer one. If I deactivate it again, it will go back to the first one. And this is the purpose of the Cinemachine brain, is to decide which virtual camera to use. For now, I'm just going to delete the other one, since we only need one virtual camera in this tutorial to follow the player. If you check the inspector on the right side, you'll see there are two empty fields of type transform. We've got follow and look at. Simply, we just drag the player into these two fields. And you'll see the camera is adjusting. If you don't like the position of the camera, we can go to body and then play with the follow offset. For the x-axis, I'm just gonna put 0 here, and the y, you just slightly put it up. The z, just drag it till you find the good distance you want. And then the aim. At the moment, it's aiming at the feet, so just slightly pull up the y-axis, and now it's in the center. That's cool. If I hit play, we can see now that the camera is following the player, but there is a bit of jitteriness here. Go to body, and then the yaw damping, just increase it a little bit. Now it's a lot smoother. To make sure that these changes are saved during play mode, make sure to check the save during play. If it's unchecked, it will just reset everything to its previous values. But now we want to save it, so just check that. Now it saved everything. So let's get into this red and blue or cyan rectangles and understand them. Before explaining them, I'll just make the camera look at the player but not following him. Assign follow to none. And now we've got the dead zone and soft zone. Soft zone is the cyan rectangle. And then we've got the dead zone, which is this area, the empty one. And what it does is, it's just a margin to tell the camera when to follow or look at the player. So if I run the game now, the camera will not act until I reach the end of that dead zone. So if I get back inside of it, the camera will stop. If I try to get to the limit, the camera will start looking at the player. So if I reset the dead zone back to zero, you'll see that now the camera is fixed on the player. The player is always in the center of the screen. And that's it for today's tutorial. In the next tutorial, we will see how to create something like that, switching between cameras to get the best view for the player. But for now, we'll just stop here. So that's it for today's tutorial. If you got any questions or suggestions, just leave them in the comments below. And to get more of these videos, remember to hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is uploaded. This is Omar Balfiki. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.